Now that I had a student come friend who used to spend a lot of time with me, he had a bachelorate from another city, he was staying in a PG type of accommodation. So he had all three type evenings and all that, he used to hang around, come with me to various places. So with many a time, I used to, you know, give him lunch, dinner, whatever, marry with me. Went down for quite some time, till he went back to his hometown, got married, brought his wife, took a place on rent, and set up a house. One of the things that he wanted to do was to invite me home for a meal. He said, up till now I didn't have a house and all that. Now that I have a house, I have a wife, etc., you know, why don't you come and have a meal with me? I said, fine. We fixed up a date. Now, he had spoken so highly about me to his wife that she was quite concerned that, you know, my new husband's old teacher is coming, so I need to, you know, do something. So she spent the whole day, you know, firstly getting the house set up properly to look neat and nice, putting up new curtains, cleaning up this and that. She went personally, bought all the vegetables, this, that, brought it home, brought out the best of crockery, cutlery, prepared very good food. And then when it was time for dinner, she said, you people eat, I'll make hot chapatis and give you one by one and all that. Anyway, we had the meal and it was exceptionally good, particularly coming from a young bride. So I turned to her and I said, fantastic meal. After that time I've had such nice thing. Everything was so nice and so tasty and things of that sort. I really appreciate it. And I must tell you that I had a good meal. She looks at me and says, no sir, I hardly know how to cook. Just 6 months back I graduated out, and when my marriage was fixed last few weeks, my mother just taught me a few things and all that. I cannot cook so far, I'm just learning, sir. Sir, my mother, no, she's a very good cook, sir. When my mother comes to visit, you must come for a meal, you'll really enjoy it. Now let us do an analysis of this sort of statement or whatever she said. When I praised her saying that the food was good, she negates it by saying, no, it is not good. So what is the message to me? You stupid fellow, you don't know the difference between good food and bad food. Second thing is, even if you found the food was good, I am not comfortable receiving compliments. So please, keep away. Don't, you know, praise me. On top of that, thirdly, she compares her food with the cooking of her mother, who's probably been cooking for 30 years. Obviously, the mother has to be a better cook. The grandmother will be an even better cook. The chef in Taj will be an even better cook. Who asked you to compare? I said that meal was good, but she has made it a point to compare. Now, I'm not a very important person in her life, it's okay. But her newfound husband, and that too it was an arranged marriage, he hardly knows her, he's just getting to know her. What is the message that she conveyed to her husband? I told you, number one, I'm not a good cook. So even if somewhere he had started liking the food, he would say, no, she herself has said she's not a good cook, no, so that means I'm not getting very good food cooked by my wife. Second is, even if you find the cooking good, don't compliment me. I get very embarrassed to receive compliments. So if he feels that this thing was good, he'll look at her and say, no, it's okay, forget it. I just enjoy my food and be done with it. Thirdly, compare my cooking with others. So sometime later, they go for dinner to somebody's house and they come out. And the husband says, no, see that Mrs. Rao, what fantastic dinner she gave. Why can't you cook like that? And what goes on in her mind? Firstly, he doesn't appreciate my cooking. He never gives me positive strokes. On top of that, now he's comparing me to Mrs. Rao, who's got three servants and who's been cooking for 20 years. Now tell me, who was bad to whom?
She was bad to
her. So many a time, there are people who are bad to us. They don't behave very well with us. They are not very, you know, sweet to us, or they don't even reciprocate anything good that we do. So many things happen. But
Why is it that we are bad to ourselves, particularly when others are bad to us?